Welcome to CSE Guru. In this session, we will discuss the concept of assignment operator.
Operator is nothing but it is a symbol used to perform mathematical and logical operations. So here, the assignment operator is nothing but the operator used to assign the data or result of an expression with a variable. For example, A equal to 5. If you are considering, this is the value. The right-hand side value is assigned to a left-hand side variable. So, assigning a data or result also. So, A is equal to A plus 5. So, here these two values will be added and its result will be assigned to A. So, assignment operator is used to assign data or result of an expression with a variable. It is just copying the value into memory location of a variable. So here if you are considering, the value 5 will be copied to the memory location of the variable A. So it is denoted by equal sign. So here this equal sign is nothing but the assignment operator. Right hand side of the operator assigns a value to the left hand side variable. So, if you are considering, this is the operator, assignment operator, and its right hand side value is assigned to left hand side variable. That is the concept. And the general format is variable is equal to expression. So, variable equal to value also we can give, or any expression also we can give. A equal to 10, A equal to B plus C, sum is equal to A into B plus C. Likewise, any expressions we can able to give in the right hand side. So this right hand side expression will be evaluated and its result will be assigned to the left hand side variable. This is done by this assignment operator. So the statement with assignment operator is called assignment statement or assignment operator. There are three types of assignment operator. One is simple assignment, shorthand assignment, and multiple assignment. So, first one is simple assignment. So, here the right hand side of the operator is evaluated and the value is assigned to the left hand side operand. For example, Ax is equal to 15. So, here this is 15 is a value and that is assigned to the left hand side variable and this value will be stored in the memory location of x. That is allocated memory location of x. X is equal to x plus 2. So here x value will be added with 2 and result will be stored in the memory location of x. Left operand must be a single variable. So, if you are considering in this example, left-hand side operand should be a single variable. So, you cannot able to implement the assignment operator like this. So, the left-hand side, it should not be an expression. It should be a variable only. And A equal to B. So, now the value B is assigned to A. That is the meaning. X is equal to X plus 20. So, these are all the examples for simple assignment operator. So, in this simple assignment, right hand side, if you are considering, there may be any kind of expression. And this expression will be evaluated and we will get a single value. And this we can assign to the left hand side variable. But left hand side, if you are considering, it should be a single variable only. Left hand side expression is not permitted. So, this is the example program. So, here, int a, b and sum, three variables we have declared as integer and a value we have assigned as 5. So this 5 will store with the variable a and 2 will store with the variable b and the sum is equal to a plus b means a carries the value 5 and b carries the value 2. So 5 plus 2, the answer, the final sum result we will get it as 7. So the output we will get it as sum is equal to 7. So, this is an example for simple assignment. Next is shorthand assignment. Shorthand assignment is nothing but a shorthand notation for simple assignment. And it is also called compound assignment. So for example, if you are considering A equal to A plus B. So if you are considering here, the left hand side variable is also A and the right hand side, the first operand is also A. So this we can implement as shorthand assignment. So how we can implement? That is A plus equal to B. So here this plus equal is nothing but the shorthand assignment operator. So this expression is equal to this expression. So likewise we can able to implement for other operators also. For example, if you are considering star equal to A star equal to Y. A equal to A into Y. Similarly, for division also, we can implement A slash equal to Y. This is equivalent to A equal to A divided by Y. Next, modulus also, we can able to implement A modulus equal to Y. This is equivalent to A equal to A modulus Y. Similarly, plus equal to A plus equal to Y, and this is equivalent to A equal to A plus Y. And for minus also, A minus equal to Y and A equal to A minus Y. So why we are using this shorthand assignment operator means to speed up the operations. The shorthand assignment and unary operators will speed up the execution process. Similarly, Amazon equal to Y. This is an AND operator. So, A AND equal to Y means A equal to A AND Y. Similarly for OR operator, NOT operator. Similarly for left shift and right shift. So these are all the shorthand assignment operators. This is an example program and 5 is assigned to A and 2 is assigned to variable B. So here we have implemented A plus equal to 5. So A equal to A plus 5. That is the meaning. One thing we need to remember here, the left hand side variable and the right hand side first operand should be same. Otherwise, we cannot able to implement the shorthand assignment operation. For example, A equal to X plus Y. This we cannot able to implement as shorthand assignment. Since in the right hand side first variable is a different variable compared to the left hand side variable. Whenever the left hand side variable and the right hand side first variable is same means we can able to implement it as a shorthand assignment operator. A value here is 5. We will get the expression 10 and the 10 will be assigned to variable, left hand side variable A. Similarly for B, if you are considering B equal to B into 10. So B value is 2. So 2 into 10, 20. So 20 will be assigned to the variable B. And if you are printing, we will get the output as A equal to 10 and B equal to 20. So here, this percentage D will carries the value of A and this percentage D will carries the value of B. So these are nothing but the format specifiers. These format specifiers we will discuss during the discussion of formatted input and output statements. Next, the third assignment operator is the multiple assignment. That is, assigning a set of values to different variables in one statement itself. And this is a right associative operator. So here if you are considering, the operator equal is used to assign a single value to more than one variable. That is nothing but the multiple assignment. So for example, if you are considering, I equal to J equal to K equal to 50. So if you are considering here, the value 50 will be assigned to K also, J also, as well as I. So the value, the single value is assigned to more than one operator. And this is equivalent to three statements. That is, I equal to 50, J equal to 50, and K equal to 50. So, if we need to implement normally in the sense, we need to use three statements. And these three statements will be combined into one single statement, that is called multiple assignment. So, here many assignments are carried out. It is used to copy same value to various memory locations. So, 50 will be copied to the memory location of K as well as J as well as I. For example, if you are considering here A, B and sum are three integer variables. And here A equal to B equal to 10. So, here we have assigned the value 10 to both B variable as well as A variable. And if you are checking the memory location of A as well as B, in both the memory location, the value 10 will be copied. Next, if you are adding A plus B means 10 plus 10. So, the result we will get it as 20. So, the answer we will get it as sum is equal to 20. So, this is nothing but multiple assignment. So, this is the concept of assignment operator. In the next session, we will discuss arithmetic operators.
Thank you for watching this video.